It's been hailed as revolutionary technology in the world of medicine, basically because it's less painful, it's comfortable for the doctors and for the patients, it's safe. Welcome to the world of robotic surgery.
Because of so many joints, the movement becomes like a snake-like movement. So like I have joints. So eventually what happens when we do the surgery, instead of surgery happening like this, it can happen in a bigger way.
Absolutely, it's changed the rules of the game. Because previously, let's take the example of prostate. Prostate is sitting deep down into the male pelvis. And male pelvis as it is narrower than the female pelvis. So once it is narrow, prostate is deep down, and we used to go and put our hands inside, then you could either see the hand or the prostate. It was very difficult, particularly at certain steps of the prostate removal. And with more and more people suffering from it, robotic has made it easier for us to take it out. Why? Because this is a human hand. It's got five fingers. This whole thing has to go into the pelvis. But this is a robotic arm. So it can go into nooks and corners where the human arm would not go.
The fact that there is less blood loss in robotic surgery makes it a favorite for doctors and the patients who can afford it.
Suad Musa, I come from Sudan.
45-year-old Suad Musa, for instance, has traveled from Sudan.
The last diagnosis, I have a hiatal hernia.
It may be a robot's job, but the surgeon is still the boss, guiding its every movement behind this computer console. The magnification and the 3D view grants the doctor better visibility of the surgical site.
So this is what we were talking earlier, the 360-degree movement. Now you can see this needle. I can stitch like that. I can stitch like this. I can stitch like this. I can stitch from the top. I can stitch in all directions.
First time I went and did a robotic prostatectomy, it was amazing. It was as if I was standing inside the abdomen. It's a three-dimensional picture that I got. And therefore, I was able to identify the tissues much better. I was able to save a lot of tissue damage. And I would go to precisely the point that I want on to.
This technology has also minimized surgical errors arising from the shaky hands.
Human arm has got tremors. Whatever we do, there's some amount of tremor, and therefore the tissue is not exactly pinpointed. These tremors are filtered by the robot, and the robot is rock steady and go exactly to the place where you want to. What does that mean? That means that patient's morbidity, his amount of time spent after the operation, is much reduced than with any other type of surgery, be it laparoscopic or open surgery.
Musa's operation was over in about 25 minutes, and the driving force behind India's medical cutting-edge technology thinks there are useful lessons for Kenya and Africa to learn.
Does it strike you as ironical that when you started, you were sending patients to London or to the US, and now patients are also streaming from
London,
US, Africa? Does it strike you as ironical?
I was in London just now. I came back only day for yesterday. At least 10 patients approached me, you know, want to come, please tell them to look after us well. And, you know, I said, you don't need my recommendation for, they look after you very well. For Africa, I have a special affection because you are in the same position as what we were in the 80s. Because these facilities were not available, our people had to go abroad.
Advanced medical technology tends to be prized beyond many poor countries. That means patients from such countries have to seek specialized treatment in foreign countries like India for those who can afford it.
Tell me about the interaction of Apollo and the government. What has the relationship been like?
I think my government in the beginning, except a few people, were skeptical that this can ever work. He says, how can you replicate a US thing in India? So there were few people who were skeptics. But I think I received from the right people, I could convince. And it all happened. It happened with the first hospital, because there was no funding for hospitals by government those days. So for the first hospital in Madras, they gave the funding. Then after 3 years, they made a general rule that anybody can get, if they're starting a hospital, they can get funding. So today, it is not only Apollo. The entire health space has been transformed. My efforts, but the government's actions.
Dr. Prathap says special ties between Kenya and India make it easier for Kenyans to seek Indian cure.
We need the doctors, we need the hospitals, but I think to get over this huge tsunami of NCDs, the people must learn to look after themselves. You know, you must do a little bit of exercise, do 30 minutes of exercise, do a little bit of relaxation, you know, whatever you like. If you like to dance, you're all great dancers, Africans. Dance for about 40 minutes, you know, listen to the music. So these are all relaxation models. Or be spiritual, you know, read the Bible, read Quran. You know, if you do that, that gives you the relaxation techniques. So that is very, very important.
And as for cost, the elderly doctor has the perfect retort.
The individual must learn, saying, I must look after myself. What is the use of your smoking continuously and then killing your family? You will die. It is the family who is going to suffer. Can you tell me the cost of your body? Take a guess. You will say, I'm a pretty lady, so I'm priceless. Repeat after me. 6,000?
6,000?
$6,000 trillion.
$1 trillion.
That is the cost. So now you will evolve your body. Now we will look after your body well. I think that's what we must do.
And if we all do, the threat posed now by lifestyle diseases like diabetes, heart disease and even cancer could be minimized. For Citizen Weekend, I am Anne Mawadet.